those eggs. So did you have anything with those eggs or coffee?
Orange juice and toast. Yep. Dan, last name Sprecher, S-P-R-E-C-H-E-R.
And Dan, your official title?
Captain.
Captain. And yep. How long have you been with the department?
Almost 15 years.
Almost 15 years. Yep. And, you know, in 15 years' time, it's just kind of like what I was talking to Cody, you know, this is pretty unique. What ways would you describe something like this?
I would say breathtaking. When you first come in and you see it, kind of stands out. Yeah, that's what I would call it.
And you're the painter with the
yes.
Are you a naturally born painter? Do you love to paint on your own?
I do like to paint. I'm a carpenter by trade, so it was just one of those projects that was a goal, and never backed down from a goal, so we did it.
Okay, so we've backed the backstory. So did you like going to Sherwin-Williams one day and you're like, I need your best red, white, and blue? I don't even know, forgive my ignorance, this is acrylic. Yep. What'd you use on this?
It's a latex from Sherwin-Williams. We ended up going with a couple different colors to get the right color, and then finally came up with this color that's on it.
Well, it's just beautiful, and that was part of the challenge from
Ruby, yes.
From
my yep.
understanding.
Yep.
Talk to me a little bit. So it wasn't like you just went to the paint store and you said, I need red, white, and blue.
Right, yeah. So the first time we tried painting the colors weren't as deep as they were. Because once you put it on hose, it soaks in so much. So then we had to redo the colors a couple times and to get it right. And
how many intervals did you go through?
So the painting process, each side has three coats of paint on it. And each coat was about an hour and a half to put on. Just because of the way the hose is, it's so coarse and the paint sucks in so much. That we had, that's just what it took, so.
Yeah, absolutely. And these were not young hose pipes, right?
Right, yep. They've been around for a little while, so the older they are, the more the paint, you know, soaks into it, so.
You know, it's one of those things where these would have probably just been put out to pasture over time. What would become of these if they weren't up like this?
Use them for training, some other types of training. Sometimes we just junk them. Cut the ends off and throw them away. So.
These are special for sure.
Yep.
And then I'm sure you guys hung it this weekend. Any challenges with the hanging?
Not really. We kind of planned it out beforehand and had all of our parts and pieces in line and had the manpower to come in and help out.
Leave it to some rock star and ingenuitous. Right.
Yes.
Looking up at that, how you guys got that. I mean, that's got to be pretty heavy, too. I mean, those are not, like, light, each one of them.
No,
what
no.
would that thing weigh, you know?
I want to say probably close to 500, I would think, in that range. So, with all the paint and the metal in it.
So, how many firefighters did it take to hang the flag?
Three of them on the lift. So, yep.
Yeah, Henry, right? That's pretty intense,
right?
Man.
Yep.
Wow.
Yep.
So. Anything that I forgot to ask you, Dan, that you think would be important to share?
You know, I just hope other people want to get, you know, this into their station or not even into a fire station. You know, can put it in their shop or whatever and just have fun with it. So.
I sure hope that. I think people are just going to be so inspired. But right. I think that hanging it, being 500 pounds, you're going to need some really great
firefighters. Oh, yeah.
This is a passion project.
Yep.
So.
Yep.
It's like, Matt.
Well, Matt, I'm so sorry, Matt.
It's all right.
Bad dog.
Been called worse.
I'm learning. Matt, I'll remember it now for sure. So my bad. Here we go. Okay. Alrighty. Perfect. Let me just put this clip on you. So I imagine it's an M-A-T-T for this one, right? Or
is one T.
One T. Just one T.
Yep.
Okay. See, that's the, I have to ask all the questions. those eggs. So did you have anything with those eggs or coffee?
Orange juice and toast.
Yep.
Dan, last name Sprecher, S-P-R-E-C-H-E-R.
And Dan, your official title?
Captain.
Captain. And yep. How long have you been with the department now?
Almost 15 years.
Almost 15 years. Yep. And, you know, in 15 years' time, it's just kind of like what I was talking to Cody, you know, this is pretty unique. What ways would you describe something like this?
I would say breathtaking. When you first come in and you see it, kind of stands out. Yeah, that's what I would call it.
And you're the painter with the
yes.
Passion. Are you a naturally born painter? Do you love to paint on your own?
I do like to paint. I'm a carpenter by trade, so it was just one of those projects that was a goal, and never backed down from a goal, so we did it.
Okay, so we've backed the backstory. So did you like going to Sherwin-Williams one day and you're like, I need your best red, white, and blue? I don't even know, forgive my ignorance, this is acrylic. What'd you use on this?
It's a latex from Sherwin-Williams. We ended up going with a couple different colors to get the right color, and then finally came up with this color that's on it.
Well, it's just beautiful, and that was part of the challenge from
Ruby, yes.
From
what yep.
You're
yep.
Talk to me a little bit. So it wasn't like you just went to the paint store and you said, I need red, white, and blue.
Right, yeah. So the first time we tried painting it the colors weren't as deep as they were. Because once you put it on hose, it soaks in so much. So then we had to redo the colors a couple times and to get it right. And
how many intervals did you go through?
So the painting process, each side has three coats of paint on it. And each coat was about an hour and a half to put on. Just because of the way the hose is, it's so coarse and the paint sucks in so much. That we had, that's just what it took, so.
Yeah, absolutely. And these were not young hose pipes, right?
Right, yep. They've been around for a little while, so the older they are, the more the paint, you know, soaks into it, so.
You know, it's one of those things where these would have probably just been put out to pasture over time. What would become of these if they weren't up like this?
Use them for training, some other types of training. Sometimes we just junk them. Cut the ends off and throw them away. So.
These are special for sure.
Yep.
And then I'm sure you guys hung it this weekend. Any challenges with the hanging?
Not really. We kind of planned it out beforehand and had all of our parts and pieces in line and had the manpower to come in and help out.
Leave it to some rock star and ingenuitous. Right.
Yes.
Looking up at that, how you guys got that. I mean, that's got to be pretty heavy, too. I mean, those are not, like, light, each one of them.
No,
what
no.
What would that thing weigh, you know?
I want to say probably close to 500, I would think, in that range. So with all the paint and the metal in it.
So how many firefighters did it take to hang the flag?
Three of them on the lift. So, yep.
Yeah, Henry, right? That's pretty intense,
right?
Man.
Yep.
Wow.
Yep.
So. Anything that I forgot to ask you, Dan, that you think would be important to share?
You know, I just hope other people want to get, you know, this into their station or not even into a fire station. You know, can put it in their shop or whatever and just have fun with it. So.
I sure hope that. I think people are just going to be so inspired. But right. I think that hanging it, being 500 pounds, you're going to need some really great
firefighters. Oh, yeah.
This is a passion project.
Yep.
So.
Yep.
It's like, Matt.
Well, Matt, I'm so sorry, Matt.
It's all right.
Bad dog.
Been called worse.
I'm learning. Matt, I'll remember it now for sure. So my bad. Here we go. Okay. All righty. Perfect. Let me just put this clip on you. So I imagine it's an M-A-T-T for this one, right? Or
is one T.
One T. Just one T.
Yep.
Okay. See, that's the, I have to ask all the questions.
Testing, testing. There we go. Okay. It's just giving me a hard time today. Retired hoses. What it took. Create the perfect. Oh, Mr. Henry, it's okay, it's okay, it's okay. We're gonna get this right by take 49. I'm at take 48 right now. Take 49 is gonna be great. Yep, 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 yep. Thirteen 40-year-old retired hoses just like this, plus 20 hours of painting. What it took to make this, almost got it. Take 50. 3, 2, and 1. Thirteen 40-year-old hoses just like this, plus 40. 13 40-year-old hoses just like this, plus 20 hours of painting, what it took to make this project truly patriotic. Yes, okay, I think I got it by take 51. Thank you guys for being so patient.